Use these part drawings to build a part in SolidWorks. Unit system, inches. Part origin, arbitrary. Material, plain carbon steel. This is the first example for the 2D and 3D sweeps main video. The links to that video and the other examples and lectures are found in the description below. From what we learned in that video, we know that a 3D sweep like this one will require two 2D sketches merged into one with the use of a composite curve. For this reason, we'll locate the origin of this part somewhere along this vertical segment, as this will be the point of connection between the two sketches. On the front plane, we replicate the shape of the path of the sweep, with the origin being that point of connection. We use all the given dimensions to fully dimension this sketch. For the vertical segment, we know that 1.85 is the length from the center of the sweep, meaning this sketch that we're drawing, and the bottom of the sweep for the second sketch we'll create. Since the sweep itself is a 0.20-inch diameter circle, the distance from the surface of the sweep and the center of the sketch we're drawing should be a radius or 0.10 inches. Therefore, the distance between the horizontal segment of the first sketch and the horizontal segment of the bottom sketch is 1.75 inches. Due to all of this, we want the length of this segment on the first sketch to add up to 1.75 with the length of the segment on the second sketch. For example, 1 inch long here and 0.75 on the second sketch. The actual limits for this length are given by the fact that we are going to fillet the sketches. So those limits are greater than 0.40 inches and less than 1.75 minus 0.20. Since 1 inch is within these limits, 1 inch works. Now, with the sketch on the right plane, we draw the shape of the rest of the curve and dimension it correspondingly. Notice that because we're using the origin as the point of connection, we A. didn't need to create a reference plane to draw our second sketch, and B. don't need to pierce the starting point of this sketch with sketch 1. They're already connected. We now go to Curves, Composite Curves, and join the two sketches we have. After this, we go to Swept Boss Base and select a circular profile of 0.20 inches. Notice that if we create a circle to sweep the path here, it just takes longer. And notice, more importantly, that that circle needs to be perpendicular to the path itself, requiring us to create a reference plane perpendicular to the sketch to draw this 0.20 diameter circle. If the plane we create is not perpendicular to the curve, but just vertical, when we sweep that 0.2 inch diameter circle, both ends are not gonna match what we were given. The planes on the ends will have an angle, and therefore neither the part nor its mass properties will be correct. With the correct sweep, we give it a plain carbon steel material, and we're done. The links to more CSWA type examples, as well as the main 10-minute lectures of the SolidWorks course and other engineering courses, are found in the description below, so make sure to check them out. Thanks for watching!